Hello and welcome to this tutorial about this lovely dungaree. You might be here just to watch, no problem. Or you might be here because you bought my pattern on Etsy. I will put the link in the description box down below so you can find it. This little dungaree was made for that 37 sturdy child-friendly doll. And I used as a measurement from neck to crotch, so really in the neck. I will show you. I measured from here to the crotch, and with this doll that is 16 centimeters, about 16 centimeters. But you can adjust it. If you have a body that's somewhat larger, you just cut somewhat larger strips, shoulder straps, and you will be just fine. You can adjust the length of the legs as well. This is a summer version, so it comes to her knees, but you can make a full length. That's no problem. Together with a long sleeve, I think they're just adorable. So let's dive in. Hello, hello. Let's make that little dungaree you just bought. Hello. This is the tutorial which goes along with that little dungaree pattern that you bought on Etsy or is available on Etsy. Now, as you can see, I already cut out my pieces. And I think the pattern is very clear on how you should cut it out. So let's not waste any time with that. I'm first going to finish off my pockets. Now, pockets are optional because this is the dungaree we're going to make. And I'm going to place the pockets here on the side. If you like, you can place them on the front. Or if you like, you can place them on the back, on the butt, for instance. In this fabric, I didn't make pockets because this is a busy fabric, so you wouldn't notice the pockets at all. Okay, now first we're going to finish off these pockets. And I finished off the edges. I like to do that. And in this case, it's necessary because this fabric ripcord frays a lot, but if you want to work very neat, I would advise you to zigzag or to overlock your edges of the pockets. Then I folded this seam inwards. This is still the good side. So I folded it on the good side and I'm going to stitch these little seams with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Okay, now we're going to turn them. You could cut off this little corner, but I don't do that. Okay, we push the corners out so that they're nice and sharp. Okay. Okay, so now we have something like this. Now, if you are using cotton or anything like it, then you could use your iron. I could use it, but I'm not, because I want to show you how I move along. I'm going to stitch a little line over here, and I'm going to stitch a line over here. Okay, then I'm going to fold the seam allowances over. Like this. And like this one. I'm going to do that all around, of course. And with this line, I'm going to stitch a little bit away from the edge. Because I'm going to use the edge to attach this little pocket to the dungaree. So I'm going to make a little stitch line over here. I'm going to show you in a minute. So, finish the pockets. They're completely ready to be sewn on. So I'm going to lay them aside. Now I'm going to finish off the shoulder straps. And for the shoulder straps, I finished off these lines, these edges. And now I'm going to fold them over. Okay. Pin them. And I'm going to sew this line, and this straight line. So I'm going to leave that line open. I'm going to sew this line straight down. Okay, and that for the other one as well. Okay, then you have sewn your shoulder strap along these sides. You're going to cut off this corner, turn it inside out, outside in, and then you're going to top stitch along these edges. And then you have your shoulder straps and you can lay them aside. Now we're going to do the side seams of this little dungaree. We're going to place back to front, of course, and we're going to sew that side seam. And once I'm here, I can pivot a little bit and I'm going to sew this little piece as well, of course, and I'm going to finish it off. Okay, so I did that side seam. I finished it off with a zigzag, in my case the overlocker. Then I like to do a top stitch on this line. It's optional, it's up to you. If you do it, then lay your seam to the back side. This is the back side, and top stitch. Okay, so now we are going to place our pocket on that line. And in order to do that, you just measure 4 centimeters from the top. So take a little measuring tape or whatever. Measure 4 centimeters, that's over here. And lay your pocket on. You make sure that your tip of the pocket is on that seam. Okay, we're going to pin it so it's not going anywhere. And then I'm going to sew just a millimeter. I'm leaving this side open, of course, just a millimeter from these edges. And I'm going to sew that pocket on. And I'm going to do that on the other side as well. So this is what we have so far. We have 2 pieces with a pocket. Now we're going to close the legs by closing this little inside seam. Okay, and you're going to finish that off with a zigzag, of course. You have your 2 shoulder straps ready, and you have a little piece of lining, and finish off that lower edge, that is that edge. This is this edge, because these are the armholes, but it is this edge. You can finish that off too. Now turn one of those legs and just shift it into the other one. So this is the right side, this is the wrong side. I'm going to place them inside each other. And I'm going to pin this seam, and I start in the crotch. Okay. So this fits exactly, because as you can see. Okay. Pin on the other side. I'm going to stitch this curve and finish it off with a zigzag or your overlocker. So I've already turned it with the right sides out. This is the back side. Now we're going to place the lining. This is the back side. And you have that piece of lining, but you need to have your shoulder straps in. So first we're going to lay those shoulder strips this way, so the angle points outwards, and we're going to need a little bit of seam, 1/4 of an inch seam over here, of course. So first pin this in place. And the other strap. I'm Make sure there is a quarter of a seam allowance sticking out. Okay, these overlap each other a little bit, but if you sew over this, you can see that it is going to touch each other here. So once turned over, it's just exactly right. Okay. Okay. That's nice. Now I'm going to take my piece of lining and I'm going to place that over it, making sure I'm in the middle. Okay. You see? It fits exactly. And you have a quarter of an inch to sew. Should be enough. And you're going to pin all around. You made a little mark and that fits that side seam. Or if you don't have the mark, it will fit. You see, it fits just fine. So I'm going to pin that to the other side as well, and then I'm going to sew just a quarter of an inch all the way around the lining. So all the way over here, over the lining, little corner, pivot, and make my way around. So I sewed the lining on, and these straps are now inside, catched inside. So I'm going to cut off these little corners to make turning easier. Trim this a little bit, just as you wish. And I'm going to make little cuts into these armholes, and then I'm going to turn the lining inside. Okay, I folded that lining to the inside and I top stitched. That's optional, but I love to top stitch everything, I guess. Okay, and your shoulder straps are nicely in the middle. You can see it over here, and they are laid in the corners as well. Now we're going to finish the front. You still had one little piece left. And that's this for the front. Now there are several ways to do it. Some like to make already a little case of this and place it over it. I'm going to do this my way. I like to place this with that seam allowance over the edge and pin it. And I'm going to do that to the other corner as well. Lay it quarter of an inch over the side. See? And pin it. And then I'm going to make a pin in the middle. I'm going to pin in the middle, not make a pin. I'm going to pin in the middle. And I'm going to divide this excess into little pleats, and the pleats, I want them to go that way so that this pleat is going out. And I've done this pattern a lot of times, so I know that two pleats are enough to get rid of those of that excess. On the other side, the pleat is going exactly opposite, of course. Okay, I'll show you in a minute how it looks. The second pleat is going that way. So you have something like this. On the inside it looks like this. I've pleated my excess, and on this side it looks like this, and I'm going to sew over it. And I've left on both sides a quarter of an inch seam allowance. It looks like this. I've sewed it on. Now I'm going to turn it to I'm going to fold that seam allowance to the inside and make a seam completely over that edge. Fold it, and sometimes that's a little bit difficult, but there we have pins. I like to fold this. Okay, fold it over and just place a little pin or something. Then fold that whole seam inwards and then fold it over again. So it is now like this. You need a little bit seam allowance on the inside, of course, to finish off. Okay, it looks like this. You're going to fold it over. Now you're going to fold over that seam allowance in the corner nicely, so that it is nicely in its place. I would like to place a little, no idea how you call this, but it stays. And then I'm going to fold this side seam over again. You have to finish off this edge. I think I forgot to tell you this, but in this stage you can still do that. Finish off that edge, because I like to avoid as much bulk as possible in those little clothes. So I'm going to fold this seam inwards and fold it over. So that this lays nicely and flat to the inside. So later on I can sew this on. It's a bit too far. It's enough to have it over here. Okay. Do that on the other side as well. And then I'm going to top stitch around these all four edges. Okay, so now we're almost done. You're going to make your closures, either snaps or buttons or whatever you like, and finish off the seams on the bottom of the legs. And there it is, completely finished. Finished with some snaps, and I finished the seams. Now, as I told you, you can place the pockets anywhere you want, but this pattern will fit other dolls as well. Just make sure you make the straps as long as needed. So if your doll body is longer than what this pattern is meant for, then you just cut somewhat longer strips. You could even make this a little bit higher, so wider. And this is all optional, but it is possible to adjust it to another size doll. And for the legs, of course, you can make them longer if you want. So I hope you enjoyed this pattern making. And well, see you soon with another nice pattern.